Hello everyone, I'm Olga, welcome or welcome back to my channel where you can bring your English to the whole new level. And today we continue practicing English with Dirty Dancing Lesson 2. If you haven't seen the first lesson, I invite you to check it out as well, and I would like to remind that these are a little bit unusual for YouTube. These are not going to be video lectures. These are going to be the actual practical lessons, so where we will practice English, because I want you to benefit from these videos. I want to interact with you, just like we would be sitting next to each other, just like you would be having a lesson with me. I want you to benefit from these videos. Do you want to? Then let's begin. So your first task will be just to watch the scene, and this will be without subtitles. Don't worry if you cannot catch some words, if you do not understand everything. That's okay, we will learn how to do it, we will work on it. For this moment, just watch and enjoy. Here we go.
Here's money. You mean Robbie? No, you were right about him. And where'd you get it? You said you needed it. Is this kid for real?
Yeah, it takes a real saint to ask Daddy.
Thanks, baby, but I can't use it.
What? What's the matter with you? You should take the money.
I can only get her an appointment for Thursday. They do their act at the Sheldrake on Thursday night. If they cancel, they lose this season's salary, next year's gig.
What's the Sheldrake?
It's another hotel where they do their mambo act.
Can't someone else fill in?
No, Miss Fix-It, somebody else can't fill in. Maria has to work all day, she can't learn the routines, and Jenna has to fill in for Penny. Everybody works here. What, do you want to do it? Want to take time out from Simon Says?
It's not a bad idea.
It was a joke, Billy.
She can't move.
No, it's the dumbest idea I ever heard of.
I can't even do the merengue. See? Johnny, you're a strong partner. You can lead anybody.
But you heard her. She can't even do the merengue.
She can't do it. She cannot do it.
So how was it? I'm sure that you got the main message, you understood the overall idea, and if you caught all the lines, wow, great job! Now, please pause this video, go to the description down below and download your practice file. We will be working with it just right now. Don't worry if you're watching this video on your phone and you cannot download the file. That's okay, you can download it later. The lines and the text will be on the screen as well, so you can do it later. That's okay. Now, in your practice file, you see all of the lines you've just heard in the scene, so please have a look at them, please read them, carefully, and your task is to organize these lines so that you have this complete scene. So you basically need to put the numbers next to these lines, how they go in order, so you have this dialogue between these people. Don't worry if you're not sure about some of the lines, don't watch the scene, just try to put the lines in order. If you're not sure about something, just skip it, mark it as a question mark that you are not sure. That's okay, because next we will check how you managed. Okay, so pause this video and do this task. So how was it? I'm sure that you did a great job, so let's just now check if you put all of the lines correctly, so now you're watching the scene again with subtitles.
Here's money. You mean Robbie? No, you were right about him. And where'd you get it? You said you needed it. Is this kid for real?
Yeah, it takes a real saint to ask Daddy.
Thanks, baby, but I can't use it.
What? What's the matter with you? You should take the money.
I can only get her an appointment for Thursday. They do their act at the Sheldrake on Thursday night. If they cancel, they lose this season's salary, next year's gig.
What's the Sheldrake?
It's another hotel where they do their mambo act.
Can't someone else fill in?
No, Miss Fix-It, somebody else can't fill in. Maria has to work all day. She can't learn the routines, and Jenna has to fill in for Penny. Everybody works here. What, do you want to do it? Want to take time out from Simon Says?
Not a bad idea.
It was a joke, Billy.
She can't move.
No, it's the dumbest idea I ever heard of.
I can't even do the merengue. See? Johnny, you're a strong partner. You can lead anybody.
But you heard her. She can't even do the merengue.
She can't do it. She cannot do it.
So, was everything correct? Was everything right? So let's just right now look at all of these lines, this dialogue again, and discuss a few words, expressions, and phrases. So this dialogue is pretty easy. Just to stop at a few expressions, I will show you what to pay attention to. So here is the money, that's clear. Then Penny says, you mean Robbie? Yeah, so she doesn't give the full question form, so she doesn't say, do you mean this is from Robbie? Yeah, so because it's spoken English very fast, you mean Robbie? But if you want to give a full sentence, then it should be, do you mean it is Robbie? Do you mean this is from Robbie? Do you mean this was from Robbie, or something like that? No, you were right about him. And then, if this was difficult, so look, then where'd you get it? What is this where'd? So basically, this is the shortened form, because again, this is spoken English, that's why we can write it even shorter. So where did you get it? And she pronounces it very fast. She says, where'd you get it?
No, you were right about him. And where'd you get it? You said you needed it.
Yeah, so she doesn't say, where did you get it? Where did you get it? Even if I say it fast, where did you get it? Where did you get it? Where'd you get it?
Where'd you get it? Where'd you get it?
Where'd you get it? Where'd you get it?
Where'd you get it?
That's how sometimes it is difficult to understand, to catch all of the words. You think, I cannot get all of these words, but it's because they are not pronounced in full. They are not pronounced completely, just like when we speak, when we learn the language. So it just goes faster. Which you get it? Which you get it? Try to practice it. My dear friend, if you have watched this video till this moment and you are getting benefit and you are enjoying this video, can I please ask you to devote 1 second to give a like to this video? Because for me, it will make a huge difference. It really helps YouTube algorithm to understand that this video is helpful and useful, and it will show this video to other people as well, and they will be able to find my channel too. So if you could give a like to this video, I will be super happy and thankful to you. Then this line is a perfect example of sequence of tenses. So look, basically Penny still needs money. It's not about the past. It's not like you said you needed it and you don't need it anymore. She still needs it, but because baby says you said, it has to be needed. We cannot really say you said, you needed. It is like past and present. If we say you said, then we also drop this main verb, main message. We also keep it in the past because you said, you needed. Okay, so that the whole sentence goes like a little bit step back, like in the past, yeah? Because it's not quite correct to say you said, you need. It has to be past. However, if you say it, it's not such a big mistake. It would be a mistake if you're doing an exam or some kind of test and you write you said and then you need. That would probably be a mistake, 99% that it would be a mistake, especially if it is some kind of exam. So please be careful. You said, you needed. We put it in the past. Sequence of tenses. And Johnny says, of course, it takes a real saint to ask daddy. So we don't translate it literally. It's just try to remember the whole expression. This is what you say, which means you had to be very brave. Yeah, you had to be bold in this situation. It takes a real saint. Because actually, saint, literally, this is the person who is holy. So, like in religion, we say Saint Nicholas, Saint Peter's Cathedral, for example, and so on. So, here is not about the saint person. It's just the expression that it takes a real saint to ask daddy, meaning to be very, very brave. Thanks, baby, but I can't use it. Or in American English, they would say I can't use it. If you, by the way, you are not sure when people say I can use it or I can't use it, because when it goes fast, there is no such pause. We don't say I can't use it. There is no pause. We say I can't use it. I can't use it. Yeah, and there is no such t. You will not hear it. I can use it. Or I can use it. So what's the difference then? Because in British English it's pretty clear. So you either say I can use it or I can't use it. So that's the difference. You clearly hear it. But in American English it is a little bit different. So it would be I can use it. You put a stress on the, when it is affirmative, you put a stress on the actual word. I can use it. Use it. Here is more stress. And if it is negative, so you say, I can't use it. I can use it. Yeah, so I do not say, I can't. I can use it. Okay, so that's the difference. What was the matter with you? So what's wrong with you? Why you didn't take money? You should take the money because it's still present. Yeah, she can still do it. So you should take the money. And Billy says, I can only get her an appointment for Thursday. An appointment, of course, in this context, it's absolutely clear that this is the appointment with the doctor. Because in general, you can get an appointment in different institutions. It can be an appointment with the council, in some kind of office, immigration office, anything. It can be even an appointment with a friend. So, because it's just the agreement, the exact time and date when you decided to do something, to meet someone. So this is the appointment. They do their act at the Sheldrake on Thursday night. So they do their act means they do their performance. They have their performance. They have to be on the stage. This is the act. If they cancel, they lose this season's salary and next year's gig. So gig is also the performance or series of performances, usually something entertaining. So this is gig. This can be concert, this can be dancing concert, music concert, anything like that. So the gig, again, the performance. What's the Sheldrake? It's another hotel where they do their mambo act. All clear here, right? Can someone else fill in? If you fill in for someone, you do the work or task that they normally do because they are unable to do it. So basically it means to substitute someone, to fill in for someone or to substitute someone to do instead of someone. For example, my colleague cannot come to work, so I promised I will fill in for her. But there is also one more meaning. If you fill someone in, you give them more details about something that you know about. So you give them more information. You didn't give a new team member all the details. I'll fill him in, meaning I will provide him with all the details, with all the information. So to fill someone in and to fill in for someone. These are two different things. Then Johnny says, "No, Miss Fix-It." So if you fix something, you make it work. So you mend it, you correct it, you edit it, you adjust it. So to fix, to make it work. And he says, "Miss Fix-It." Somebody else can't fill in or can't fill in. Maria has to work all day. She can't learn the routine. So these routines are the move, the actual steps in a dance, because there is also some kind of sequence of movements. So this step after this step, here is the turn, here is two steps left, two steps right, and so on. So these are the routines, meaning she cannot learn the whole dance. And Janet has to fill in for Penny, so again, to substitute Penny to work for her. Everybody works here. You wanna do it? Take time out from Simon Says. So just a small remark here, if you don't know, Simon Says is a funny game. It's super popular among American people and in English classes actually too. And the point is that someone plays Simon and he says, he pronounced it like that, Simon says, I don't know, raise your hands, and everyone does it, okay? And then he says, Simon says, jump, everyone jumps. And then he says, stop, for example, and whoever stops loses, because Simon didn't say Simon says. So you only have to act when he says Simon says, and then do something. Only then you do. If he says just the action and you do it, then you lose. That's the point of this game. It can be super funny. You can actually play it with your friends, for example. You will be laughing a lot because it does cheer everyone up indeed. And of course, Johnny is being sarcastic here because he says, do you want to take your time out from Simon Says? Kind of from something very important, but in fact, it's not important. It's just a game, something what is boring, and they are living a true life with their real adult problems. And he, in this way, he says that baby is just a baby, you know, like Simon Says she is playing here. Yeah? So she doesn't have anything important to do. It's not a bad idea, Billy says. It was a joke, Billy. She can move. It's the dumbest idea I've ever heard of. Again, present perfect, pay attention, I've ever heard. So this is the first time I've ever heard such dumbest. You do not pronounce B, so dumb. So you write a dumb, but you pronounce dumb. And if you say that something is dumb, you think that it is silly, it's stupid and annoying. I came up with this dumb idea. And then baby says, I can't even do the merengue. Merengue is a style of Dominican music and dance. It is considered to be very easy, like everyone can do it, you know, because the music goes like, it's super simple. It's like step, 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 step. It's funny, it's cheerful, and if the partner, if a man can lead a woman, it's like everyone can dance this dance. There is nothing to learn. That's why she says, I cannot even do the merengue. It's already easy, but I cannot do it. And then Johnny goes like super surprised. And you see, you heard her. Put my you're a strong partner, you can lead anybody. So as I said, to lead, so in a dance, a man leads, so he keeps a woman, he leads her in a dance, and a lady follows. But you heard her, she can't even do the merengue, she can do it, she cannot do it. And here baby is like, you'll see, you'll see. All right, you did a great job. Let's just right now watch this scene again, now without subtitles, because you already know all of the lines and you will hear them perfectly. So just now you can relax. I thank you so much for staying with me during the whole lesson till this moment. Right now I'm telling you bye-bye. I hope to see you in my next videos. I remind you to check out the first lesson and of course proceed with the next ones. And I also invite you to check out my whole channel if you haven't seen it. Check out the playlist I have, and I invite you to subscribe if you haven't done it yet. Hope to see you soon again. Until then, please take care. Bye.
Here's money. You mean Robbie? No, you were right about him. And where'd you get it? You said you needed it. Is this kid for real?
Yeah, it takes a real saint to ask Daddy.
Thanks, baby, but I can't use it.
What's the matter with you? You should take the money.
I can only get her an appointment for Thursday. They do their act at the Sheldrake on Thursday night. If they cancel, they lose this season's salary, next year's gig.
What's the Sheldrake?
It's another hotel where they do their mambo act.
Can't someone else fill in?
No, Miss Fix It. Somebody else can't fill in. Maria has to work all day. She can't learn the routines. And Jenna has to fill in for Penny. Everybody works here. What, do you want to do it? Want to take time out from Simon Says?
It's not a bad idea.
It was a joke, Billy.
She can't move.
No, it's the dumbest idea I ever heard of.
I can't even do the merengue. See? Johnny, you're a strong partner. You can lead anybody.
But you heard her. She can't even do the merengue.
She can't do it. She cannot do it.